If you own a laser cutter with a honeycomb, you're probably tired of cleaning up burn marks on your cut edges that look like this, and looking for a solution to make it look like this. I'll stick around and I'll show you how I did these. What is actually happening is the laser is hitting the honeycomb at the bottom of your material and then flashing back onto it, which causes these little marks. I used to just sand them off before I assembled, but sometimes I want those little burn marks on the ends of your boards to show through in black. And also, I didn't like that it's always that little bit thinner now. I like the tighter fit that I get if I don't sand these marks out. So the next logical step now is to actually put some masking tape on the bottom end of what you're going to do. Now this works well, and I've been using this quite extensively, except it also takes a lot of time to do this if you've got a big amount of cutting to do. So you can see an intricate design that's been masked beforehand, but to take off all the masking now out of a design like this, the tape keeps tearing, etc., etc. It actually takes a lot, way too long, much more time than I would like to spend on it most of the time. So if you're doing simple stuff with a lot of straight cuts, not a problem. You can do this all day if you like. But if you're gonna run a production line where you're really gonna try and actually make a business out of this, then there's just not enough time for all of this. This got me thinking, there's got to be a better way than this. The answer is, of course, to lift your workspace off of the honeycomb. Now, this sounds simple, but it's actually a bit more involved than what you would think, because there's certain criteria I wanted this to have. So the first thing I did when I got my S1 was to position the honeycomb in such a way, spaced out, so that I know exactly this little corner here that you see on screen is always going to be my origin corner from where I can actually put any design. And it's repeatable. The second thing was I wanted these spaces to not be in the way of the maximum cutting area that I have on my machine. Which means that I want these parts to index the board in exactly the same place. So by lifting the board, you're actually creating a draft underneath your material, which will pull the flame away from your work surface, which results in much cleaner cuts. On my machine, I need an 8mm space in the front of the tray and then move the tray all the way to the back and then move the honeycomb all the way to the right. This means if I put my indexing mark right on that corner, it will line up perfectly with my honeycomb. And this is what I came up with. So these are ticking all the boxes for me now, because they are doing all the different things that I expected from them. The first thing they need to do, they need to index this corner for me, so that I know if I put a board in there, it's going to be indexed as if it was actually laying flat on the honeycomb. Now the magnets are optional, but I like having them. Just makes positioning a bit better, and you can also, if you have the riser base, they can be stored next to it or against it. Now you can see if I position a board into these now, then it will line up with my honeycomb perfectly, so that I have the cut spacing that I used to have on the flat honeycomb bed. I made the footprint as small as I possibly could, at about 8mm from the side, so that you don't lose more than that from the corners if you wanted to cut all the way to the edge. And the little flat supports are also very handy, because you can use them to support the board where you need to cut very close to corners, for instance. And because of that ridge that they have, you can still position them perfectly into that corner. Here's a little time lapse. As you can see, very little smoke on the top. Everything is being pulled down to the bottom. Cuts are very clean and neat. It's almost as if the cutting performance is a bit better for me as well. As this is normal red MDF, it's not even the proper stuff. And that's it, right out of the machine, there you can see, no burn marks. Yeah, I just thought it would be cool to see what's going on inside the machine on the parts that we normally cannot see. As you can see, it's still lying very low. It still indexes it perfectly, lying on these spacers. They pretty much lifted about 4.5 millimeters higher than they used to be, which obviously is well within the reach of this machine. I did make lower ones in my testing, and if you go too low then you get flashback again, so this was the lowest that I could go. I wanted it as low as I possibly could, because if you cut something very thin it can actually fall and bounce on the honeycomb and end up underneath your laser. So if you have small parts that you want to keep, it might not be the best bait to use this, but for everything else, if you want clean cuts on these type of boxes and stuff, it works perfectly. So I hope this video saved someone out there a bit of time and effort. If you like what I do and you would like to support the channel, just like and subscribe, it's free. If you want an option that's not free, you can buy one of my design find files. That is very much appreciated. The link to that is also going to be in the description. And yeah, I hope I see you all in the next one. Cheers, guys.